the title itself, The Unmarried Wife, is already, I think, intriguing enough. Bakit wife? Bakit unmarried? So it's a wife who is torn between her choices between two men, her husband and her lover, but it's not your typical love triangle. Who is the husband and who is the lover? Yun ang kailangan niya. At bakit unmarried wife siya? Yun din ang isa pang kailangan niya.
I think the adventurous type of character at the same time could be a very loving, submissive wife and loving mother, devoted, but at the same time could have a fun, wild side.
I think it is a matured approach towards the eternal triangle. It is a new look into characters na played by the three protagonists. Tapos paano sila nag-i-interact. Of course, there will be love scenes. Siyempre, it's part of the psyche of the woman, di ba? Or the psyche of every human being na kasama yung eros doon eh. So, nag-i-express sila ng love through their physical qualities or their physical involvement. Tapos, ang tingin ko sa pelikula ay isang it's a dissected look into a certain kind of relationship ng matured people and looking at their innermost needs, yung emotional needs, kesa dun sa mga maingay na interaction. These are matured young men who participate into a relationship that they themselves are afraid to go into and yet are adventurous enough to go into. Yung parang ayaw at gusto na nila pasukin. I'm excited to work with the three of them. Angelica, I've worked before with, with her sa Love Story. Si Ding Dong sa aming mga telenovela. At si Paolo, nung siya'y nagsisimula pa lang. So, telenovela din. So, ngayon, established actors na sila at artists, mas exciting siguro. Tapos, at the same time, you're tackling a very... Kumbaga sa natatimely rin kasi medyo ngayon, empowered ang babae eh. Diba? Masyado silang adventurous na they go into relationships which they regularly did do before or openly did before, di ba? Parang ngayon, mas empowered sila, mas emancipated. So, parang it's a look of how a woman is at present and how she can handle herself and how she can get out of it, perhaps, di ba? Dito sa kanila, dahil yung nakikita ko yung na pwede akong mag-approach on a different level na hindi na yung pang-bagets, hindi pang-ano na. You talk to them on characterization, you talk to them on how I want the scene done, o kung ano yung gusto kong makita. Hindi na yung descriptive na, hindi na ako kailangan umarte. Di ba sila na yung gusto kong i-draw out from them. That's the approach that I'm looking forward to.
Oh, after more than a couple of years, andito ulit for a project and I'm very excited dahil yung tema at yung kwento nito, very, kumbaga, it's happening talaga sa mga relationships na nakikita natin at that we know about around us. So, very appropriate din na matakil siya. So, excited ako dun sa kwento, sa tema, tsaka sa kabuuan, dahil syempre sa mga kasama ko. And of course, I am excited to work with Star Cinema once again. Syempre, alam naman natin kung gaano kahusay si Angelica and yung experience ko working with her was fantastic and one of the most memorable projects that I have done. So, I'm sure, especially now, with this kind of A-material, mas magiging exciting daw.
My last film for Star Cinema was, I think, Pagpag. They played the ghost there, so it's actually my first film in Star Cinema as a contract artist, and I'm quite excited to work with Star Cinema again. Especially, it's also I think my first time working with Kuya Dong for a film, for full length film.
target according to production is 24. So, nasa ano na yan, nasa writers na. Lagi na mag-pressured sila eh.